on this one. This is a three-unit residential building, it'll be 40 feet tall. So I did call for that one. Another one, which I just called in, is 200-214 Van Ness Avenue, the San Francisco Conservatory of Music. And this is a proposal to demolish the building that's sitting there and the building behind it that's an 11-story building and build a 380-student bed project. But it also includes 30 dwelling units, which consists of 27 to replace the housing units they will be tearing down that are rent-controlled. And there's open space for the residents as well as for the students in the building. And another project receiving environmental review is 1850 Bryant Street, which is Bryant 17th and Florida Street, Mariposa on the south. They plan to demolish a building and parking lot and storage lot and build a 5-story plus over basement, 166,000 square foot mixtures building with 18,000 square feet of production, distribution, repair, as well as this is social service building. Building permit applications. 3490 20th Street. It plans to convert an existing office building into restaurant, commercial, office, and residential. 1906 Market Street at Herman and Laguna wants to change. I talked to Dennis a little bit about this one. He wants to change the use of a laundromat into a restaurant and retail use. Senator Board of Supervisors, item 3 on land use, which was yesterday. I hate getting these things the day afterwards. They talked about the exclusionary affordable housing fee and dwelling unit mixed requirements by Sophia Breed and Tang, which would revise the amount of the exclusionary affordable housing fee and on-site, off-site affordable housing alternatives and other exclusionary requirements. And under 30-day rule on land use, Peskin has authored administrative code ordinance on residential hotel status report requirement, requiring a yearly report to the Board of Supervisors on the status of residential hotels. Also under 30-day rule by Peskin, Kim, and Rohan is an owner move-in reporting and abuse for a change to amend the planning code required landlords seeking to recover possession of rental units based on owner move-in or relative move-in to provide a declaration of penalty of perjury stating the landlord tends to occupy the unit as a principal place of residence or for the landlord's relative for a period of a minimum of 36 months. And under public safety, which is tomorrow at 10:30 a.m. in room 263 at City Hall, there's a liquor license transfer for 708 Oak Street, Type 48 on sale general for SAC S period, A period, K period bars at the Hotel Epic. There's also a hearing sponsored by Sheely to consider the state of and understand the efforts by the city departments regarding youth homelessness in San Francisco, requesting the Department of Homelessness and Supportive Housing, Department of Children, Youth and Their Families, Department of Public Health, Health and Human Service Agency, and the Youth Commission to give a report. And under 30-day rule, there's a public safety sponsored by Cohen, Sapphire, whatever, Reed, Farrell, Sheely, and Tang is an ordinance to amend the health code to prohibit tobacco retailers from selling flavored tobacco products, including menthol cigarettes. Also under 30-day rule, There's an ordinance, a police code, ordinance sponsored by Sheely to recodify and revamp the permit process and procedures for getting a permit.